everyone. Welcome to Shady Grove. Good to see each one of you here today. Visiting with us. We're certainly honored to have you. We want you to feel right at home. Y'all bear with me. I got a couple announcements. We've got today, Crossroads Baptist Church is having a deacon ordination. Brother Taylor Samples, Eddie Floyd, and Randy Head will be ordained today at 2 p.m. today at Crossroads. Next Saturday, there'll be a Galentine tea party at 1 p.m. here at Shady Grove Fellowship Hall. It says, ladies, please wear your best hat and bring your favorite small bite. If you've got any questions, see Meredith on that. Meredith, you got anything to add?
No, there's no age requirements or anything.
Okay.
As long as you're a lady, we'd be happy to have you.
Really?
Well, thank you very much for doing that for us. That's very kind. Very sweet. I'll go ahead and mention next Sunday would be ordination for Brother Nathan Hester. He's been ordained to Pastor Mount Tabor. His ordination will be at Harmony Grove next Sunday at 3 p.m. Go ahead, young ladies, mark your calendar for your next youth group meeting. Be here in the Fellowship Hall at 12:30 after church on the 20th. So y'all keep that on your calendar. And there's one more ordination. It's from Dawsonville Baptist Church. It's on that February the 20th as well at 2 p.m. It's Brother Stan King and Shane Lively will be ordained as deacons that day. So be put in prayer for that. Mark your calendars. We'll announce that again when it gets a little closer. Any other announcements? Anything I've missed or messed up? All right, well, prayer requests. Remember all those on our church letter? All those that's lost loved ones, there's been quite a few. Remember all those battling cancer, sickness? Everybody's being quiet today. They want me out of here real quick.
I have a prayer request. The Vodder's family, Christy's daddy died yesterday with COVID.
Thank you. Remember that family? We'll jump into our birthdays. I believe we need to go back to the 12th of January. Larry Watson. We sing to you, Larry? Don't make me dead. Stand up. Take a pop, grab it. Today, Miss Carrie. What? On Tuesday, the 1st of February, Robert Hurd. Friday, Billy Carnes. Abby Hurd on Friday. Amy, did we sing to you? I don't think we did. Stand up. Any others I've missed? Anybody? All right. Well, let's sing to y'all.
Happy birthday to you.
Come on now.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yes, Jesus.
church camp. So let's sing it all.
I've had to take a trip. turn to page 482.
Thank you.
good singing this morning. Love to hear voices at the church. This really does me good. Hear the ladies singing off their part and the men singing their part. It's just beautiful. We enjoyed it this morning. Thankful for the good playing, good song leading, prayers. Missed the organ player this morning. Hate seeing that organ closed up like that. That's not how we want to see it, is it? But pray everybody's doing okay. Just keep praying. I know it's been mentioned already this morning about a lot of sickness, a lot of death, perilous times that we're in, it seems like, in this old world. But we know who's in control and who has all power. And my trust and hope is still in Him. And I pray no matter how bad it may be, no matter how bad it may get, my trust and hope will always be in Him. Tried to pray, seek out the Lord's direction for this hour, to pray our hearts. Prayer and desire is that you would be fed from the Master's table today. You would receive something to stir your the spirit within you, stir your soul, and you would be able to receive something that would do you a lot of good. That's something that is of the Lord. We pray we could just be used as a mouthpiece for Him. We thought about a journey. We want you to think about your journey this morning. You know, a thought is we all begin to come into the Lord's house and how thankful we are for the newborns that we have here at Shady Grove and how precious they are. They just get more beautiful every day. You can just see the increase in their beauty and how they grow change so quickly, but their journey has just begun. Their journey here on this earth has just begun. God sent them as a gift and brought them into this world, and they've got a journey before them, and nobody knows what their journey will hold, what ways that it will take them, the turns and places that their journey will take them, but we all pray that it'll be a good journey, don't we? We all pray that they'll be safe on their journey. The Lord will bless their journey, bless their way, and then some of us, we've traveled a long way already on this journey, and many miles, and got a lot to look back on and think on. Some of us have come a long way in our journey. And so we're all, each and every one of us here today, we're on that journey of life. And we've been set on, and the Lord has blessed us and brought us into this world and set us on our way. And we've got instruction for this journey, and I know that we serve a God that wants us to have a good journey, a good way. Thought about Abraham. You know, as God had called Abraham out, He called him one day. God spoke to him. He said, rise up and take up thy goods and thy family, all that you have. And he said, I'm going to send you to a place that you know not of. And Abraham was obedient unto God. And Abraham rose up as God instructed him and began to go on a journey that he knew not of. And that's really the journey that you and I are on today. It's a journey of faith that we know not of. We don't know what tomorrow holds. We don't even know what the next minute or the next hour or the next day holds for any of us. We really don't know what's ahead on our journey. And I know that it's through God's great wisdom and knowledge and His purpose and plan for each one of us that we're not able to see too far ahead. We're not able to know. The Bible says we walk by faith, not by sight. And I want to encourage each and every one of you in here today, and those that have traveled a long journey, you've learned along the way, you've realized that walk by faith is much greater and much more enjoyable and much more prosperous than to walk by sight. A lot of times in this old world, we try to walk by sight and we try to figure out our way and plan our way, but the Lord tells us to walk by faith, not by sight, and to trust Him along the journey. And every part of the journey is important. From these youngest ones here today, this day is a very important day to them. I thought as Jesus loves me was led, and how a lot of times we look at that as a child's song, but it's not. It's a child of God song. And how those little ears, I thought maybe they were thinking, well, the whole church is singing, Jesus loves me. And I believe that made a difference in those little ears this morning. And it spoke to them. And something that they was able to receive on this day in their journey, that it'll make a difference in their future walk of life. And each one of us, no matter our age today, we're at a very important part in our journey. Every step matters, doesn't it? Every step of the way matters. There's not a step that you and I take that's not important, that's not part of the journey of life that God has set you on. And so it's important that we cherish each step and that we make each step in a way that would be pleasing unto the Lord. You want to follow along in the Bible? You want to turn to Luke in the 15th chapter of the book of Luke. Thought about it in one place. The Bible said that Jesus, He said, I must needs go through Samaria. And He knew that there was a woman over there that was on her journey of life, and that she, that journey would be taking her that day to Jacob's Way. You know, we never know where we're taken to some of the places that we are in life, why our situation takes us to one place or the other. But that little journey that that woman was on that day was just another journey to the well to draw water the natural way. She didn't have no idea what that, she had made that same journey to that well many times. But she didn't know on that day that journey was going to be a lot different than it had ever been before. And there it was, the Bible said, as Jesus got there to Jacob's well, it said He was wearied by the journey. He was wearied by the journey. Even Jesus became wearied with the journey. He was flesh, just like you and I. He was man, just like you and I. He became weary along the journey. And each one of us, and maybe some of these younger ones hadn't grown to the time in their journey to realize it yet, but oh, we all grow a little weary along the way, don't we? Their steps seem to get a little long sometimes, or maybe the journey seems to be upward, like we're always climbing a hill and having to climb upward. But Jesus even grew weary with His journey, and He sat down there by the well. I want to start reading here in the 15th chapter, in this 11th verse. We're going to start in the 11th verse, and these words are in red. Jesus spoke these words concerning God and the love of God and sinners. The Bible said, and He said, a certain rich man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living. When he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in the land, and he began to be in want. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine. And he would fain have filled his belly with the husk that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. When he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my fathers have bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of thy hired servants. And he arose, and he came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. But the father said unto his servant, bring forth the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet. Bring hither the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found, and they begin to be merry. And I believe that's all that the Lord would have us to read this morning. And I want you to think about that journey. Now, and I believe with all my heart that we've been put here by the divine purpose and plan of God. I don't believe that any one of us was an accident or just circumstance, but I believe God had his divine hand in your birth and in your being conceived in your mother's womb and being brought forth into this world. And I believe it is pleasing in the sight of God that you are here in this world today. And listen, he has a great desire and a will and a purpose for your life. Here we find the Bible said that a man had two sons. Here it was, the Bible said that the father, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of the two sons came into the father. And he listened to what this young man began to desire in his heart. The Bible shows us that this young man desired to go on a different journey than what he was on. You'll notice there it is in that 13th verse. It said that he took his journey. I want you to think about that this morning. This young man began to look at the journey that he was on. I believe, Billy, the journey that God put him on, and he began to desire something of it. Oh, I believe it's very important if we want our journey to be prosperous and if we want things to go as the Lord would have them to go in our lives. Abraham was the example for you and I today. I'm sure that Abraham didn't want to take up and pack up and leave the place and the people that he knew and go to a place that he knew not of. But that was a journey and a purpose for God in his life, and why God had sent him here to take that journey. This young man decided he wanted to go on a different journey. He wanted to make his own decisions and go his own way. He wanted to go on his journey and not the Lord's. And there it was, the Bible said that the Father granted him that he asked for. How did he begin to go out? The Bible said he took his journey to a far country, and there wasted his substance. This young man, as he got out on his journey, there he began to make unwise decisions, and he began to experience a journey that was not meant for him, and it was not purpose for him. I thought about Paul, and I read a little bit about Paul's sufferings this morning, and how that Paul had a journey, didn't he? Was first Saul, and then God named him Paul. Now he was on Saul had been on a journey that was not the Lord's, and how that God got him on the right path that day and sent him in the right way that day and changed his life. Listen today, I want to encourage you, if you're not in the right way today, and you're not on the Lord's path, on the Lord's journey today, that you would get right with God, that you would call upon the name of the Lord, that you might get on the right way, on that right journey, that be prosperous. Now we look at Paul's life and we see how hard his journey was. He was persecuted, and the Bible describes a lot of all that he went through for the cause of Christ, but that was a journey that God had chose for him. That was his purpose in life that God had chose for him. And at the end of his journey, oh, listen what he was able to say. He was able to say, listen, I've fought a good fight. I've kept the faith. I've finished my course. Now there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which my Lord, the righteous judge, shall give unto me that day. And then he said, not only to me only, but unto all them that believe upon him. Oh, listen, we got a journey to go on. It may not always be like, listen, this young man that desired to go on his own journey. He thought he could just choose his own way, didn't he? Get that inheritance, and he'd have all that he needed to go out in this whole world. I want to tell you, and we, most of us in here already know it, this whole world will consume you. It will eat you up, chew you up, and spit you out. It doesn't care a thing about you. It just wants you goods. Wants to use you and take you for its own benefit for a little while and then get rid of you. This young man, he realized he got out there on his journey. That famine came in the land. There's a famine in the land today. It's not a bread and water. It may be someday soon. But right now it's a famine of the Spirit of God. This young man got out there and he began to experience that famine. And if you get out of the journey that the Lord has set you on and you choose your own way, I can promise you you'll find yourself in a famine. You'll find yourself without. You'll find yourself just as this young man did. Begging, listen. He had everything that he needed there with his father on the journey that he was supposed to be on. But when he chose his own way, he became a beggar. Listen. Eating that even the swine would need. Listen. The lowest of low is where your own journey will get you. It may be prosperous for a little while, but listen, I'm sure that this young man enjoyed that inheritance for a little while, but then he soon found himself eating that the swine wouldn't even eat. And I'm going to tell you, they'll eat just about anything. If you've ever slopped the hogs, you know how nasty of things they can eat. Listen, this man was eating what the hogs wouldn't eat. And there he was. And the Bible said he came to himself. Oh, thank the Lord today. When somebody comes to themselves, it's a glorious time. It's a wonderful time. This young man came to himself. I'm thankful today that one day I came to myself. And guess who was still there for me? Oh, the Lord. Even though I got off on the wrong journey, he didn't forget about me. He kept his eye on me. Listen, he knew exactly where I was all the way. There was this man. He came to himself. Listen, he got humbled, didn't he? That of his own way. He humbled him. And he realized that he had left that good journey that he was on. He got off on the wrong way. And the Bible said he began to realize this. And he began to reason and make sense and say, I'm going to go back there. And he said, I know I'm not worthy now to even be one of my father's hired servants, but I'll ask him if he'll just consider me back. just to be one of his hired. Listen, I want to tell you something this morning. Oh, the Lord has got a purpose for you. Oh, we are the children of God. We are the to receive the inheritance of our Heavenly Father. Oh, and He's got riches untold stored up for you and I. Today He's got things. Oh, listen, planned for you. It's just important today that you stay on His journey, the journey that He has set forth for you. And don't get out on your own. Just stay humble before the Lord. Just continue to know and believe in all your heart that He knows better than you know for yourself. He knows better than we know. He can see and knows all things. There it was, this young man. The Bible said he had joined himself with the citizens of that country. Now there and then set him in the fields to feed the swine. He had had to just join up. That journey that he had chose to go on, join up with people that didn't care about him, people that wasn't willing to sacrifice for him. Oh, listen, today I want to tell you something. When you got people that love you, you got a mom and daddy, grandparents, a church, a Sunday school teacher. Oh, listen, whoever it might be, an aunt and uncle. Oh, I want to tell you they love you. They're willing to sacrifice for you. They're willing to give. Listen to what they have, that you might be okay, and that you might be fed, that you might be able to prosper. But you get out in this world just like this man was. Then people didn't care about him. Listen, they didn't love him. They weren't willing to sacrifice for him. And there he was among them people. He began to realize what he had lost. The Bible said, he said, I will rise and go to my father's house there, saying to my father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. Oh, that we might realize when we get off, listen, when we get off and out of the way of the Lord, that we might realize where we are in life, that we might come to ourselves, that we might repent and get back on the journey that God would have us to be on. He said he wasn't no more worthy to be called his son. But what happened? What a beautiful picture of God we see here. As Jesus began to speak of this about these two sons, his father that had these two sons. And what a beautiful picture it is of Christ and oh, of the Heavenly Father that you and I have today. Oh, listen, the father of these two sons, listen, he had worked hard to be able to provide for his family. He had worked hard to be able to provide protection and food and whatever they might need. I want to tell you, there has no one ever worked harder than your Heavenly Father has worked for you. There has no one ever went as far as he went for you. And there will never be no one that will ever go as far, and it could go as far as he went for you. For God so loved you that he gave his only begotten son. Oh, today, listen. This father had worked so hard for his sons. The Bible said he began to make his journey back. He began to backtrack, didn't he? He began to go back from the way he once went. Oh, listen, the Bible said it. That father saw him coming a long way off. He didn't make him come and beg, did he? He didn't make him come and get down on his knees and apologize. But listen, the Bible said it. He ran to him and he fell upon his neck. He embraced him and he kissed him with great compassion and love. Oh, we'll just come back to the Father. He'll be there ready and waiting on us. And we won't even have to make the journey all the way back. Oh, listen, he'll meet us before we even get there and let us know that he still loves us and that there's still what they need waiting. The Bible said, this father said, go kill the fatted calf and get my best robe. I'll get the shoes for his feet and the ring for his finger. Oh, listen today. Oh, the father had what he needed these tracks back from where it comes and get back on that right journey that the Lord had set him on. Oh, listen, today Abraham was so faithful. Come with a song if you would this morning. Abraham was so faithful there before God to go. Even as I thought on that journey that Abraham took, all that Abraham experienced on that journey, and all that he saw that God had planned, listen, that you and I might be able to have that journey that we have today, that walk of faith, that journey that we can go on, that we know. You know, I'm thankful to know, Russell, that this journey that the Lord's got me on, he's not going to leave me off in a hole, is he? He's not going to set no stumbling stones in my way. Oh, listen, he's going to go before us. The Lord said he goes before us. I thought about the ladder that we read about in Sunday school this morning. Jacob's ladder, the Bible said he saw in that dream angels ascending and descending. What were they doing? They were doing the work of the Lord for God's children. They were coming and being ministering spirits and moving the stumbling stones out of the way, clearing the path for God's people today. Oh, listen, God, don't put no temptation in front of us. Oh, listen, he doesn't tempt us with evil. Oh, he clears a way for us if we'll just stay in that journey of life that he set for us. Abraham, there he had to offer his son up as a sacrifice. Remember that, Isaac? His only son that God had promised him. God told him along that journey that he was going on. It was God's journey. He said, go offer thy son Isaac up as a sacrifice. Oh, Abraham didn't understand and he didn't know, but he stayed on that straight there, didn't he? Oh, he stayed. He rose up early. He stayed on that straight there journey of God. And he gathered the wood, the fire. He gathered everything and he went to that mountaintop. Isaac asked and said, Father, you've got the wood and the fire, but where is the sacrifice? And Abraham told him, said, son, God will provide a sacrifice. Oh, he stayed on that journey. He didn't step off and say, I can't do it, God. But he stayed faithful and true to the journey that God had put him on. And he found a sacrifice, didn't he? Called in the thing. Woo, listen today. You stay on that journey that God's got you on. Young folks, listen. No matter how tough it may seem, it's not always an easy journey to stay in God's way. But if you'll stay on it, there'll be a sacrifice always waiting and ready for you. Oh, that you won't have to suffer death, but you'll be delivered in the spirit and the power of God, that you'll experience life and life more abundantly. Oh, that's what the Lord wants for you today. Stay on the journey. Let's stay in church. And let's say you stay on the journey that God's got you. Well, I don't know. Well, if you're not sure what it is, you get on your knees. You talk to the Lord. You use the altar that God set aside for you. And you come and talk to the Lord. And you let him know that you need help to be able to see your journey clearly. That he might lead you and show you the way. Oh, let's sing, church. Won't you come if you need to come this morning? I'll get you mount, get you journey there before you, so you can go the way that God would have you to go. Sing when you're ready.
Page 541. Thank you.
trip up Golgotha's hill, bearing the burden of sin of the whole world upon his shoulders. The heaviest load that could ever be carried by mankind, Jesus chose and was obedient to carry it. There to Calvary's cross, he made the hardest journey that will ever be made. And there he did it just for you and I. He left the portals of glory. He left the throne room of God, seated at the right hand of the Father, to make that journey there through this old world of sin and sorrow. And he did it because it was the journey that God had purposed for him, that he sent him on. And look today, he said he was obedient there to the death of the cross for the joy that was set before him. That journey has made his a joyous time there of seeing lost boys and girls, men and women saved, that he might be able to save their souls. Through being the sacrifice of God. And that joy is beyond measure for Jesus Christ because he stayed obedient, stayed on the journey that God had set for him. Anybody have a word or testimony in any way?
God, you mentioned the woman at the well. So I'm thankful for that 12-year-old boy on the journey.
Yeah.
I got invited to go camping and go to revival. I didn't know what revival was, but yeah. I got invited to take a little trip, take a little journey.
Yeah.
Just like her, she went to that water pot. I didn't go camping. I was just going camping.
Yeah.
And I came out of there with the most precious gift I could ever get.
Amen.
I know I've lost away sometimes along this journey and stumbled and failed, but I'm thankful that my Lord and Savior has always been there for me. He never gave up on me. Like you said, he's always there.
Yeah.
And I know inside of my heart, everything, my one desire will be to always make him happy and honor him in everything that I do, if any way possible. I know sometimes I don't. But my true heart's desire is to always honor him, and every day that we're given this opportunity to feel that day and honor him and know that he is who he is and he'll do what he says he will. I just thank him. I love the Lord.
God bless you. Chris, anyone else in any way? You know, we'll ask Siri and we'll ask Google Earth. We'll ask all these different people we don't even know. I don't even know if they're real or not. You know, I asked Siri one time if she knew Jesus Christ as her Lord and Savior. She said she was silicon, and she could not relate. It was not of the of spiritual, could not be spiritual. I believe something to that nature. You know, we seek out different ones to get us from point A to point B. I tell you, we need to be calling on the name of the Lord for this journey that we're on, that we stay in the way that he would have us to stay and not seek guidance through any other than seeking his guidance first and finding the way he would have us to go. Anybody else before we dismiss? A lot of hard work and money and effort put into this building right down here called the Fellowship Hall. It's a wonderful place. And it's just as much a part of the church as any part. And thankful we're going to get to go down there and fellowship together and eat together on this fifth Sunday. So thank you for all your labor of love, all of you that cook. And everybody's invited. It's not for just those who brought food. The ones that brought food brought it forever for you, and so don't, you know, just don't tell nobody. I've said it before, nobody will know. just come eat and enjoy us. We hope everybody will stay if you can. Remember, let's continue to remember all those on the prayer list, the sick, those that have lost loved ones, and And let's do, let's consider our way and think about the things that are on this way that you're on. If there's things on this way that you're on that are not of God, most likely you've made a wrong turn. You're in a way that God would not have you to go. So consider, just like that young man did, he began to consider his way. We love you. God bless you. We'll go ahead and have a blessing on the food and dismiss this service. Brother Matt Martin, would you dismiss us, please?
Kind, gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for each head that's bowed here today, Lord. Thank you for this little church that we've been able to come to all our life, Lord. And Father, we just thank you for the many blessings of life, Lord, that you have blessed upon us here at Shady Grove. And Lord, thank you for our pastor. Lord, thank you for his family that come in and out before us. Lord, thank you for this message today. Lord, may we take it with our lives this week and quiet our hearts. And Lord, we just thank you for this food that's been prepared today, Lord. We just ask that bless the hands that's took to prepare it, Lord. We just we pray that we take the nourishment of our bodies and our bodies to thy service. In Jesus' sweet and holy name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.